sip from my devil's cup. Slowly, it's taking over me.
It's a show that has taken the country by storm, and Glee's popular leading man, Matthew Morrison, is a huge part of the show's success.
And now he's releasing his own album and preparing for a nationwide tour. We are joined by actor and singer Matthew Morrison. Matthew, welcome.
I'm a dancer, too.
You are a dancer. I'm sorry for leading that out, of course. Hey, so, Matthew, first off, I'm reading about what you guys go through on Glee. I thought you show up for an hour and have a bunch of body doubles do your stuff. But you guys work 15 hours a day sometimes?
It's a brutal schedule. And I think I'm a stupid human being for trying to release an album at the same time. But I mean, Glee has really afforded me the opportunity to do that. It's an amazing show, and I love what it stands for, and I love the message it has every week.
Yeah, no kidding. You got to strike when the iron's hot, right? So that's why you're doing the album.
Yeah, you know.
I want to talk, before we get to that, I want to talk about the famous guest stars who you have had a chance to sing, dance, and do some other stuff with. First, there was Britney Spears.
What was that like?
Honestly, I didn't meet her. She was very, you know, they kind of kept her very isolated on the set.
Oh, really?
What a
okay.
shame. All right, but Gwyneth Paltrow, I know you for sure met her because I think you kissed her.
I did kiss her. I did kiss her. That was a good moment in my life. Getting paid to kiss Gwyneth Paltrow, I was like, all right, I like this job.
And she came back, and she's a bit of a somewhat goofy, eccentric character on the show. Is that the way she's like in real life?
No, not at all. She's like the most down-to-earth, normal. I mean, you think this Oscar-winning actress who is just so well accomplished, and she's just so normal. And I think she's just amazing. But Glee is so great for that. It really, you get to reinvent yourself. And I mean, I didn't know she sang before this, and now she's everywhere singing. It's amazing.
That is, as far as her career going in a different path. Then there was John Stamos and Neil Patrick Harris. He's been on our show a lot. Kristen Chenoweth on our show as well, and Molly Shannon. All these people have been on our show. So what is it, do you think that people want to recreate themselves when they come on Glee, or they just want to come on because it's such a popular show?
I think it's a testament to the writing. The show is so well written that it's just such good material, and as an actor, you you know, you really crave and you hunger for good material right. to do. And I think that's why people are drawn to it.
And just be honest with me, actor to actor, the first thing you do when you find out they booked a hot, famous person to be on the show, you try to find if there's a kissing scene with them. Am I correct?
No, I went to the writer's room and made sure there was a kissing scene.
Very good answer.
Because you got power.
All right, let's talk about your new single, your debut CD, your solo tour. Tell us about it.
Like I said, Glee has really afforded me the opportunity to make this other dream of mine come true. You know, this is something I've always wanted to do, and life is so short, and I just kind of want to do it all right now. I mean, there's so much more stuff I want to do in the future, but it's been a passion project of mine to do this, and it's great. I thought it was really important to write my own songs on the album, because otherwise it just would have been another Glee CD. Mm-hmm. So the songwriting process for me was really just kind of special, and a great opportunity to show who I am as a person, instead of, you know, because people think of me as Mr. Schuster now. So it was a good opportunity to express myself. Yeah.
Although it's never bad to be known as the hottest teacher.
I don't know where that's coming from, but thank you.
Yeah, it's just coming from our crew. Camera 2, Scott, said that. I'm not sure.
Thank you, Scott.
Speaking of hot, I'm assuming that you know that you've been linked to Olivia Munn.
Yes, I do know that.
How's that going?
It's not going.
No, it isn't? That's all you say.
No, she's a friend of mine. That's the thing. Like, you can't have friends in this business anymore.
I know.
I've been linked to so many people, but it's just like, you know, you can't win. You can't go out with someone without, you know.
Okay. So, Matt, let's break the mold then. Tell me some of the friends that you go out with that are just friends. And you want to correct the record. Do you just want to go hang out with, I don't know, Raquel Welch? And you don't want to make sure there's a story there.
Yeah, I mean, God, I have so many things going on in my head right now. Yeah, no, I mean it's a weird thing. I don't understand it. I mean, I get it. It's just the kind of the culture we live in now that everyone...
People care about you.
In a roundabout way, Brian was trying to find out if you have a girlfriend. Yes or no?
No, I don't. I don't.
All right.
All right. So the new album, the new tour, and you're going to have some exciting things with your opening act. You have an opening act competition there. But we're going to find out all about it. Matt, thanks so much for joining us, and congratulations on all your success.
All right. Thank you. Have a good morning.